Welcome to Trading ST. We're watching right now Palantir Technologies. What's happening, Enrique?
Let's see what's going on. Look at that movement to the downside for now. What is going on, guys? Let us know in the comments below. First of all, remember to read the disclaimer right here and also in the description below. Wow, what an uptrend that we experienced with this stock. We are talking for a year today. Let's see the exact percentage, 118.4% just right now. Maybe this is a different number when you see this video, but wow, more than 100 year today. They joined the S&P 500, obviously good news, and that those were, you know, projecting the price. But will this be a normal correction, or will this be the start of the movement to the lower side? How do you see this last movement? Let us know below.
Yeah, even though they entered, you know, into the S&P 500, the reality is like they have still a size. The size is very small, you know. If you think into consideration Apple, Nvidia, or other big mega cap stocks, it's like if we have a reaction in those stocks, the S&P 500 could be affected a lot, you know, and vice versa. But with Palantir, you know, they entered, you know, the last, so obviously it's not the same thing. Still, the uptrend is absolutely nuts, and the fundamentals are absolutely incredible.
Yeah, this movement, you know, this last upside from that. Correction, we have to mention also the kind of crash that happened before this with that gap to the downside, also minus 28% more or less, and from there the movement to the upside of plus 80%, those who bought at the lower side, you know, that movement. And for now, what we have is from this last level, a movement of minus 5% more or less. So if we take into account the basic technical analysis right here with a trend line, remember that we are using the logarithmic scale. So this may differ from your chart. You can see like the breakout with the candle of today may have occurred already. But if we change to the non-logarithmic scale, you can see what happens. We should like draw the trend line in a different direction, and this level could be holding yet. So that's why we always recommend to see different perspectives and to not be biased. And my question for you is, do you think this breakout has happened or not? And do you think these levels in the lower side will be reached before they reach higher levels? Or maybe you have a different opinion and you think like this won't reach higher levels. I want to know your opinion for this stock, because I think it's in a very, very interesting moment.
Buy or sell Palantir Technologies. What I would sell, you know, what I would actually sell, no, what I would say is that, you know, if we have a breakout to the downside in both charts, logarithmic and non-logarithmic, that would be like something to take into consideration. So if you have like only round breakout, you can wait for the second one, because maybe it doesn't happen. But if it happens in both type of charts, wow, that could be something. Let's take a look at the forecast, Enrique, because obviously you see the price action, we don't know what's going to happen, but the fundamentals always help in that sense.
Yeah, let's see that forecast. I think it is very, very interesting section that we have right there. I'm not opening the tab for me right now, so you can see that.
Yeah,
14 analysts. Yeah, I can see it right now.
14 analysts. 14 analysts.
Yeah, nice coordination. go ahead.
Yeah, the thing here is like the second quarter that we have right here, that we have an estimate of 0.09, and the next one a little bit better, the next one actually the same, and you know the in the second quarter 2025 we're talking about like a 0.11. Okay, what I'm trying to say with this is like we don't have much growth in comparison to the previous forecast, but also, you know, in the previous forecast there was an estimate of 0.08 in the last three quarters, and then it was beaten three times. So it could happen the same in the next ones.
Yeah, also from the analyst forecast for that 1 year price, let us know in the comments your opinion and your own forecast if you have one. You can see the maximum $50 plus 38%, the average minus 24% more or less, $27 around that number, and then the minimum one, very, very negative, minus 75%. So which one do you think is more... Do you agree more with? And let us know in the comments if you have a different one. And going back to the chart, I want to, you know, to share the picture of the stock in the monthly time frame. You can see right there. And this is a very interesting moment from the price action perspective, because the price has been approaching those levels, you know, that were being traded during 2021, those highs right there. So a key question for you also, guys, do you think this time will be the same and these levels will be rejected again? Maybe the sellers have started to sell again at that territory, or do you think this time will be different and why? Let us know in the comments below.
Something important is analyze the fundamentals at that time. We are not talking about the same thing, because at that time we had negative net income like in all quarters. And right now we are in positive territory. It's something, you know, that we compare the data and we see, well, okay, it's trading at the same levels, but we are not trading at the same fundamentals. The fundamentals are way better than before.
Okay, so guys, what is your opinion for this stock from the fundamental side, technical side? Everything you want to share with us, let us know in the comments below. Thank you very much for watching Trading HD. Check out all the videos right here, subscribe, and let's go. Trading HD, honest traders.
Thank you very much, and see you in the next video.